Some say that racing is in every horse's blood. Whether one thinks of racing as occurring on a track, surrounded by thousands of cheering spectators, or on the untamed plains of the West, the urge, the instinct to gallop freely, remains the same in every horse. It is sometimes hard for humans to understand, but for a horse, the ability to run is as important as a human's ability to breathe.
Rio was a promising colt, born on April 27, 2004, at a prestigious thoroughbred farm in New York State. The descendant of a famous bloodline, Rio was conceived with the potential of being a truly great racehorse. His future was supposed to be like that of his great-grandfather, four times removed, war admiral, and his great-grandfather, five times removed, man of war. With the proper care and training, Rio was set to be the next Barbaro. But excitement and expectations turned to disappointment when Rio started having problems walking. He was unable to get up without assistance, getting cast in his stall on a regular basis. From a glance, Rio was obviously favoring his left hind leg. The problem soon became too serious to ignore, and the caretakers at Winterbrook Farm knew that Rio needed professional attention. They called in a local veterinarian to examine the foal and take x-rays of his legs. It was discovered at the age of 8 months that Rio had bilateral tarsal bone collapse of the PIT and distal intertarsal joints, otherwise known as collapsed hocks. The bones were actually thinning due to low bone density. So when stress was applied to his legs, even the minimum stress of his own body weight, the act of walking or standing became an almost impossible task. Rio also had a grade 4 lameness, which meant he was experiencing significant pain. This was evident when he would walk and his legs would visibly shake. Because of the severity of the problem and the lack of any known treatment at the time, the recommendation was made to put Rio to sleep. Rio, in the condition that he was in, had no chance for a normal life, let alone the chance to survive beyond the next few months. Eventually, over time, as he got bigger and heavier, he would not even be able to get up under his own strength. His future, what was left of it, would be filled with pain and suffering. When it seemed like the world was about to give up on this young colt, a woman named Mary Bogdansky and her family decided to try one more test on Rio. A local resident of Norwich, Connecticut, Mary had long held a passion for horses and had recently heard of a treatment that might actually provide Rio with an option other than having his life cut short. With the farm's permission, Mary had an alternative test done on Rio called a hair mineral analysis. A hair mineral analysis is a test that measures the mineral content of a person's hair, or in Rio's case, an animal's.
Rio was kept at the barn where I keep my horse Penny, and in talking to the owner there, she filled me in on what his health problem was and how rare and how there was no treatment for it at this point in time. And with her permission, I decided to go ahead and do a hair mineral analysis, which is an alternative test that tells you what the level of minerals are in his body. The first thing we had to do was take a sample of Rio's hair. That involved cutting a piece from his mane and sending it to the lab. The test would show us what minerals were going to be low, what minerals were going to be high, or what imbalances he was going to have, or even some toxic minerals in his system. Because nutrition plays a big role in a foal's development, this was important to see if he had all those bone-growing minerals in his system, which consisted of calcium, phosphorus, magnesium, zinc, and copper. Why we were waiting for the test and to give him a boost, since we weren't sure, is we did put him on a vitamin mineral supplement that had the vitamin minerals that he obviously needed to grow the bones, but also some extra things, some anti-inflammatories and some joint food, which would be conjointment sulfate, sodium hyaluronate, some devil's claw for the anti-inflammatory, glucosamine. Those things would help his bones and joints while we were waiting for the test. The results of Rio's hair analysis showed that he had a toxic level of aluminum, which prevented him from absorbing and utilizing all the bone growing minerals that he needed, which was again the calcium, the phosphorus, the zinc, and the magnesium. What it also showed was that because he wasn't here living long enough on his own to get the aluminum, studies have shown that it was passed from mother to baby through the placenta. So that's how he got his level and why he was born with some birth deformities, because he wasn't able to get what he needed in his body at the proper time while he was developing in his mother's womb. The report also showed that he had high toxic inflammatory stress, that he was sensitive to sugar and carbohydrates, and that he also had a hard time recovering from stress. It also showed us that if he didn't have the aluminum present, that he would have been born normal without any genetic defect. Rio's inflammatory stress showed up in him as low bone density, which caused his collapsing of his hocks. Inflammatory stress and the subsequent symptoms shown in horses are directly related to the level of toxic aluminum in their bodies. Since each horse is genetically unique, inflammatory stress can show up differently in each horse, even though they may have the same bloodlines, mother, father, and relatives. It is possible to test a number of horses with the same inflammatory tendencies and all of them still having different symptoms and conditions associated with it. In some circumstances, the symptoms that do show up in horses can vary widely, and this is because of genetic strengths and weaknesses of the individual horse.
Every horse will have inherent strong and weak points. Whatever the genetic weaknesses are, this is the most likely area that inflammatory symptoms will occur. The genetic weaknesses of Rio that became the most pronounced was Rio's inability to hold minerals in his bones, which kept his bones from calcifying properly. Aluminum is by far the most common toxin that is found in horses. Aluminum exposure can occur from airborne aluminum, commercial grains using certain processing techniques, and the effects of acid rain on soil that increases aluminum's uptake into the pasture. Aluminum affects calcium metabolism, bone mineral reserves, and will imbalance the metabolism in the direction of the dominant imbalances.
With Rio's hair mineral analysis results, we were able to start a treatment that could save him. So the decision was made to go ahead and adopt Rio and start treatment right away.
Rio's treatment consisted of a custom vitamin mineral supplement with other ingredients to support his bones and joints, and more importantly, detoxify his body of the aluminum. He was also put on restricted exercise of a maximum of 2 hours a day by himself. There was the danger of his legs breaking if he was put in with other horses. Rio's treatment was started with a lot of faith and prayers. Nearly 16 months later, faith turned into reality when Rio's x-rays showed his hocks were no longer collapsing. He was over the first hurdle. His symptoms of not being able to get up and stand and walk without shaking disappeared, and he was put on unrestricted exercise to help his hocks get stronger by laying down new bone. This new bone then would stabilize the hocks, so Rio would no longer have any pain or lameness. The question now became, would Rio be healthy enough to one day have someone ride him? At 2 years of age, Rio was not only standing and weighing in at a healthy 900 pounds, but also doing things he would never do before, like running, bucking, rearing, and even playing ball. Due to his improved condition, Rio no longer had to be alone any longer. After 19 months, he could finally be put in with other horses and socialize.
Having reached the first goal of this unknown journey, Rio still faces many challenges ahead. There is still one more year to go before he'll be strong enough to really be ridden. And veterinarians will have to continue to monitor his bone growth and density.
But since those early days of worrying and uncertainty, the impossible happened. Rio's hock stopped collapsing, something most people didn't think would ever happen. But because of an alternative medical test called a hair mineral analysis and a formulated custom supplement, Rio beat the odds. The custom supplement, based on his body's chemistry, gave him the ability to get rid of the aluminum and let his body absorb and utilize the minerals needed to rebuild his bones.
So just because one woman took a chance on an ailing horse and tried a relatively new and alternative treatment, Rio is alive today. But Rio's story doesn't end here. He still has one more year to recover completely from his condition and show everyone who doubted his recovery that he would and could do it. And because Rio is running again, stronger than ever, with a new lease on life, perhaps one day he too can make a name for himself with his famous ancestors.
Find myself singing the same songs every day.